This is the doubles final of the USCA Master Seniors National Championship. Stuart Jackson on the right and Peter Yust on the left shared top seeding in this doubles competition along with Jackie and Fred Jones. They've come in with blue and black and are on the west boundary about halfway between hoops one and two. Mike Gibbons and David McCoy playing red and yellow have a wide join in corner two, and here comes the first attack. Trying to get the wiring and peeling options balanced just right. I've edited out most of the consultation that goes on in these doubles games for sake of brevity, but this gives you a flavor of how these guys make decisions together. Since it's early in the game and a missed shot at blue would give Stuart Jackson all four balls, David opts to send red to the west boundary and see what happens. Stuart Jackson's had a lot of peeling experience. He's been playing all over the world for decades. I think his AC grade is about 2200. And at minus two, he and Jackie Jones were the top seeds in this tournament. Period. Stuart's not playing singles, though. Let's see how this works out. A little extra roll on black guarantees that there'll be no dead ball fault. Nicely done. He wanted that rush to red. I hope the graphic is obvious. This shows that he's made one back. His clip is now on two back, and the blue clip is on hoop three because it was peeled. David McCoy, playing red, has been the major leader of the Croquet Foundation of America and the current success of the National Croquet Center. He was inducted into the U.S. Croquet Hall of Fame in 2014. As you can see, Cynthia and Mike Gibbons are the sponsors for Court 6 here at the NCC. Mike has been a major contributor and sponsor of Croquet both in New York and Florida for many years. I had the distinct honor of playing doubles with her in the Osborn Cup in Central Park about a month ago. This is Blue's hoop, but Yellow, having missed Red in an attempt to build a break, is now guarding Blue's shot on Red and probably discouraging it. I had missed Yellow's shot over to the boundary. That's Charlie Alexander doing the board keeping, but he hasn't cleared Black's deadness on Yellow yet. I have to come up with some way to communicate with these board keepers. Black has a rush to its hoop at three back. I wonder if this reward is going to be worth the risk. in yet another version of the not quite unhittable leave. Those two balls aren't as close to the boundary as he would like, but yellow is so far away that it's probably functionally the same thing. Blue has a rush to its hoop. The spent ball is a pioneer at the next hoop. And yellow's in corner three. Of course, because yellow now has a pioneer at his hoop, if he hits, he has a laid break. I must admit, these guys are confusing me now. Either blue or red is probably first ball in the last turn, and why blue didn't get off the lawn, I don't know. He may have hit hoop five accidentally. Red is clean, makes a fabulous shot on yellow on the boundary. And yellow is either last or next to last, and because he was only live on red, he now has to attempt this reverse takeoff to one back. The body language suggests that Peter and Stuart justifiably think this is over, but a few of us notice that this is the Gibbons court, and it would be wonderfully coincidental if he could pull off the miracle. Look at that, the dream remains alive. He's only down by four hoops, and he does have three balls on the lawn. But it's not to be. So congratulations to our deserving 2017 Seniors Masters Doubles Champions, Stuart Jackson and Peter Yost.